There's nothing like the warm, luxurious feel of a pure new wool carpet. Its soft and springy fibre will retain its colour and beauty for years. And though there have been many attempts to duplicate its unique properties, there is still nothing quite like pure new wool. Nowhere is this better known than at Axminster, in the heart of the Devonshire countryside, where a world-class industry has grown up over the last 250 years in the manufacture of pure wool and wool-rich carpets. For the discerning customer, the quality, craftsmanship and lasting beauty of a professionally fitted Axminster carpet make it both an enhancement and a shrewd investment for the home or establishment. And here at Axminster Carpets, there is a manifest pride in their craft, which the company's workforce display at every stage of the production process. Testament to the deeply rooted tradition of craftsmanship and technical excellence, which has been built up over the years. But how did a special commodity such as this first come into existence? To find out, we have to go back to the middle of the 18th century. In those days, only the very wealthy could afford to walk on a carpeted floor. Until, on Midsummer's Day in 1755, a local cloth weaver by the name of Thomas Whitty wove his very first carpet by hand, subsequently named Axminster, the market town where he lived and worked. At that time, the weaving process was so laborious, the completion of each carpet was heralded by the peal of Axminster church bells, and a procession of the carpet to the same church where it received a blessing before being dispatched. One of Whitty's carpets can still be viewed today at Saltram House near Plymouth. His house and original factory can still be seen in Axminster itself. Today, Axminster Carpets owes its success to a man who, in 1937, restored the art of carpet making to the town. The late Harry Dutfield was born in Scotland in 1908. Affectionately known by his workforce as the Governor, he put Axminster back on the map, re-establishing the production of quality carpets in the town. In 1950, Harry Dutfield purchased the old mill at Buckfast, Devon, close to the famous abbey. After extensive restoration, it has since become one of the finest spinning and dyeing mills in Europe, which today supplies all the yarn for the Axminster Carpets Group. But how is a pure new wool carpet actually made? Well, to find out, it's back to the countryside and the humble sheep. Wool buyers regularly attend auctions held by the British Wool Marketing Board, which handles all the fleece wool grown in the UK on behalf of 80,000 sheep farmers. There are well over 40 million sheep in Britain and more pure breeds than in any other country. Two-thirds of the wool grown is used in quality carpet production, and Axminster Carpets Limited incorporate more than 95% British wool in their carpets. We purchase particular types of resilient, hard-wearing British wool most suited to Axminster carpet weaving. Before an auction, the buyers select and value from many sample bales of wool to be sold. They are looking for colour and the length of the staple, but in particular for strength and bulk. It is these characteristics which distinguish British wool as a premier carpet fibre and have contributed to the worldwide reputation enjoyed by Axminster Carpets for the appearance, quality and wear of its ranges.